Hi, Stewart Jeske with JEI Structural Engineering. I'm going to talk a little bit today about the importance of being able to secure reinforcing inside of moyens, vertical moyens, and horizontal moyens, so that it is engaging the moyen where it needs to be for loads. The first area that I want to talk about a little bit is about horizontal moyens and reinforcing that we would put inside of horizontal moyens. So this is a solid tubular extruded horizontal moyen. And so if we had to reinforce this, say for a 10-foot opening or a 12-foot opening or even greater, what we would need is some reinforcing that goes inside of it. Now, here's the importance of securing whatever we use as reinforcing. If this is a tubular reinforcing out of steel or something like that, we want to make sure it just doesn't sit there on the bottom of the moyen. Because if it just sits there on the bottom of the moyen, it's creating additional load to the aluminum moyen. And it takes a long time, a lot of deflection, for it to actually engage and support the aluminum moyen. So it's really important for us to be able to fasten at the ends of the horizontal moyen and also the center of the horizontal moyen to make sure that this reinforcing is always at the top part of the horizontal moyen and it's actually doing the work to keep the aluminum moyen, which is the weaker part, from deflecting downward. And that's the important part. We actually had a case where out in the field, we had several different moyens that were reinforced over a tall wall, and it was over an entry area, and they were seeing a lot of deflection. And whenever we asked in the field, we asked them, you know, how was this secured? How was the reinforcing secured inside the moyen? And they actually indicated it wasn't. It was actually just setting in there, and so it was actually causing additional deflection of the horizontal moyens. So that's one item that I wanted to talk about. The other is with a horizontal moyen, if we have an infill plate, as is seen right here, this is a bottom infill plate, it's important that we do not load that infill plate or shim off of that infill plate because it may cause too much load for that infill plate to be supported. So in this case, we wouldn't be able to shim this reinforcing into place. We would need to have connections that actually connected either through the tongue into the structural shape, or we would have to have some type of connections in through the top part to be able to actually engage that reinforcing inside of the horizontal. But it's very important that we do not load the infill plate because it's just a snap-in plate and we don't want to overload that snap-in plate. So that's horizontal moyens and what we would see in terms of securing the reinforcing inside of that. The other item that I wanted to talk a little bit about today that we've kind of found out in a field that's important is securing reinforcing inside of vertical moyens as well. The importance of that is if we have some type of a reinforcing that might be a bent plate, something like this in the shape of a channel, and we try to put it inside of the vertical moyen for reinforcing, the vertical moyen actually has a lot of distance in there that it can actually deflect back and forth before it actually engages in it. And so the appropriate thing that we need to do with this reinforcing to be able to engage it and make sure that it moves with the wind and that there's not noises in the system is that we would either have screws that actually engage this at the horizontals, where the horizontals go through, or again, we would need to shim this reinforcing into place to make sure that there's shims at the ends and in the middle so that it adequately engages that reinforcing and makes sure that it does not deflect until it reaches the reinforcing. One of the items that we experienced in a project with reinforcing of vertical mullions was where we had some very long and tall runs of vertical tubular mullions, and we had some type of a reinforcing that was a bent C channel that was supposed to be inside of it, and we actually received reports from inspectors in the field that this channel was not straight. It was actually bowed and out of place inside of the vertical mullion. They were somehow they were able to gain access to the inside and look and see what was going on, and so it was not appropriately shimmed or attached at the horizontal mullions. So very important for reinforcing to be adequately connected to the mullion at the ends and at the horizontal mullions or shimmed.